Hello students, now we will be solving memory based questions of GATE 19. For more video solution on GATE 19, subscribe to our channel and don't forget to click bell icon for instant notification.
Hello guys, in this video we will be solving questions from the subject Engineering Mathematics and the topic is differential equations with variable coefficients. So as you can see that this is the differential equation that you need to solve. The conditions are given that y of 1 is equal to 1, y of 2 is equal to 14, and you are required to find the value of y of 1.5. This is the differential equation you need to solve. So you can see that this is the question from differential equation of variable coefficients, and in variable coefficients you know that the first substitution you need to take is x is equal to e to the power z, right? So and the second after some manipulation the automatically it becomes, this becomes d of d minus 1 into y, and x dy by dx you write as capital D of y. Capital D denotes d by dz. Fine. So substituting this, it will become d of d minus 1 y minus 3 d of y plus 3y is equal to 0. So I have made the substitutions and I will only simplify it and find the values of the quadratic equation. Fine. So 3, the auxiliary equation that I am going to get is m square minus 4m plus 3 is equal to 0. Fine, this is the quadratic equation that I have got. On solving it, I'll be getting values. The two values of m is, 1 is 3 and m2 is 1. Fine. So the complementary function is c1 e to the power 3z plus c2 e to the power z. Fine. Now e to the power z you have taken as x, e to the power z you have taken as x, so I can write this as x cube e to the power z whole cube, so x cube plus c2 into x. Fine, I have transformed in terms of x. Now you need to find the values of c1 and c2. Conditions are given, so y1 is equal to 1, so 1 is equal to c1 plus c2, this is the first equation, and y2 is equal to 14. So 14 is equal to 8c1 plus 2c2. We need to solve these two equations. Let me solve this. And I think you will be getting values as, the values that you will be getting is c1 is 2 and c2 is minus 1. C1 is 2 and c2 is minus 1. And on putting this, I'll be getting 2x cube minus x is my final complementary function, and you need to find the values of y of 1.5. So y of 1.5 is 2 into 1.5 whole cube minus 1.5, and the answer that you will be getting again is 5.25. Fine. So just you need to know the method, the substitutions that you need to make, and after you make the substitutions, it is only going to be, means you just need to focus on the calculations and ultimately you will be getting the answer as 5.25. So this is it. I hope you liked the video, and if you find this useful, please do share it with your friends. Thank you.